ఇంతేనా ఇంకా ఎవరైనా వస్తారమ్మా? స్ట్రెంత్ ఇంతేనా ఇంకా ఎవరైనా వస్తారా? సో మనం ఎగ్జామ్ టైం టేబుల్ వచ్చింది, మీకు ఐడియా ఉందా లేదా? హలో, ఎగ్జామ్ టైం టేబుల్ వచ్చింది, మీకు ఐడియా ఉందా లేదా?
సార్
ఎప్పటి నుంచి మీకు బంధం?
19 సార్.
మన ఎగ్జామ్ ఎప్పుడు? బిడిఏ ఎప్పుడు?
24 సార్.
24 25?
24 లాస్ట్ ఎగ్జామ్ సీసీ సార్.
అవునా, దానికి ముందు ఎగ్జామ్ ఎప్పుడు?
23 ఆర్ 24 సార్.
ఇంకా కన్ఫ్యూజన్.
23rd
సార్ మన ఎగ్జామ్.
23rd, వెరీ గుడ్. నేను డేట్లు వచ్చినాయి కదా, దానికి ఎందుకు అంత కన్ఫ్యూజ్ అవుతున్నాను? నేను ఇది నోట్స్ అంతా మీరు ఆ గూగుల్ క్లాస్ రూమ్ లో చూస్తున్నారా లేదా తెలియట్లేదు. సో నేను ఏం చేస్తున్నా అంటే వాట్సాప్ లో పెట్టాలని ట్రై చేస్తున్నాను, కానీ ఎందుకని అప్లోడ్ అవ్వట్లేదు. వాట్ ఎవర్ ఇట్ మే బి, బై ఈవినింగ్ యూఆర్ గుడ్ టు బి గెట్ యువర్ ఆల్ పీపీటీస్ అలాంగ్ విత్ టెక్స్ట్ బుక్ అండ్ ఐ కలెక్టెడ్ సేమ్ పీడిఎఫ్. మనం పీపీటీ కాకుండా పీడిఎఫ్ అయితే చదువుకోవడానికి మీకు కంఫర్టబుల్ గా ఉంటుంది అనుకుంటే పీడిఎఫ్ ఫైల్స్ కూడా పెట్టాను కొన్ని. అంటే ఐ థింక్ చూసారు మెఫా క్లాస్ మేడం ఒక చూసారు కింద కేవీఆర్ సాఫ్ట్వేర్ సంథింగ్ సొల్యూషన్స్ అని వస్తుంది కాబట్టి చూసుంటారు మేడం చెప్పారు. సేమ్ అదే బ్లాగ్ లో వి హ్యావ్ అవర్ సబ్జెక్ట్ పీడిఎఫ్ ఆల్సో. ఓకే, సో I will send you that copy, that link. If you want, you can download and you can get all the notes over there. Once again, I will... I will send you... So this is a message. I'm sending message to all. Either you got a message or not, can someone tell me? So if you send one link, okay, you can take that link and you can download any subject PDF over there, exact what from your syllabus. So please select your 16 syllabus and from that you can download each subject you have not. If any subject if you are not finding in IT department, you can go to the CSE in the same, what is that? Same thing, same syllabus is there, you can download from the CSE also. So, I think, have you received that website? So, copy that one and keep it for all semesters we get it. Because next semester also we have some theory along with the project. Also. So, that only is very needed, okay? So, in sake of, we need to think about the examinations. So for that, I want to refer the PDF as well as along with the, what is the PDF which I downloaded from this KVR software blog. So first we will go to that blog, what is the syllabus for unit 1 is there and what is the notes we have. So we will check one by one and we will conclude along with our PDF also. By that you can easily understand and easily compare with my class easily. So now I'm going to see, what is the unit 1? Can anyone remember what is the unit 1? Unit 1. So unit 1 is data structure in Java. Okay, this is the thing we are going to be discuss. So you can take this way, say print out order it maybe for reading purpose. You can go along with this PDF. Same thing only, but in my PPT, somewhat extendable explanation may you get it in that. So, but for exam purpose, you can write it. This is enough, I think so. So, but we need to find out the what is the question and what is the concept for that one. We need to find. Okay. So, screen is visible to everyone. Can someone answer? So, first one is a data structure in Java, unit 1. Data structure in Java. So the collection of framework provides the interface and the class implementation that enable to data handling easy and meaningful. Use the collection, one can store, retrieve and manipulate the data very effectively and easily. Before we will start, let's discuss the architecture of a collection of framework, that the hierarchy of classes and the interfaces. You see the diagram? I think the diagram is visible. So let me, I'm zooming. So this is the one. So the hierarchy iteration, that is a street structure that is iteratable. We have a collections. So you know the meaning of iterations means all the things we, so list, queue and set we have. In the list we are going to be discuss about array list and linked list and vectors. In the vectors we have a stack. And queue, we have a priority queue, DQ, NQ, and DQ, and array queues. And the set, we have hash list, hash set, linked hash set, and the sorted set, and tree set. So this is the hierarchy of these classes and interfaces, how we are going to be doing. So we are going to be talking about Java, that is. So the collection interface resides at the top of the hierarchy, although the Java does not provide a direct implementation of collection framework, but interface being implemented by the list sets, list and set classes. So directly we are not going to be provide an interface. So whatever it, generally we are writing program, we are going to be getting. So interface something and by extended, we are going to be write the things, no? The same thing. Okay, like that. So the first one is about data structure. So can anyone know what is a data structure? What is the data structure? Why you want to talk about data structure? So there itself is the meaning is that data structure is a specialized. The specialized format for organizing and storing data. So that is the meaning about organizing and storing a data. So why we are struggling with the big data? What we are going to be doing with the big data? So if the little bit of data is there, that we are going to be organize, and we are going to be see what is the inner view of data and how the data is going to be useful to the users. Okay, that is, so organizing data, so how we are going to be setting and storing. So at order of the day, we have to know about how come we can store data efficiently. If the storing is there, definitely the organizing, which data we can organize. If once we organize, what we are going to be doing, where we can store, where we can retrieve the data in order to make organization. So these are the things we need to talk and we need to see in the so generally once again. Okay. So we need to organize and organize the story. So once we can the topic of storing. So why we want to store your data? So some other day we are going to be using for the data. If there is no use, we are going to be simply delete. So we need to know about storing means in order to retrieve the data. So we more often we specify. The storing is not only a storing, it means we need to retrieve the storage data where it will be stored. So general data structure types include the array, the file, the record, the table, the tree, and so on. An array data structure is designed to organize data to suit a specific purpose so that it can be accessed and worked in the appropriate way. So that is data is designed and organized, designed to organize. So what type of data we are going to be handling? So what type of variables we want to use? What type of structures we are going to be use? So how it, for example, simply we can talk, whenever we are going to be talk about enter your mobile number, is there any different formats are there in the mobile number? For example, we can consider only the India, only the Andhra Pradesh, only for example, I'm going to be collect the data only the CRE department, the engineering student mobile numbers. For that purpose, if the data whole level, we are, my aim is to collect the phone numbers in CRE college. Is there anyone number having mobile number having less than 10 numbers or is more than 10 numbers? So if the data is fixed size, if the data is known, so the type of data is like this, then we fix that which data type we need to use. So we need to save a memory, we need to save the time for the execution also. For example, if we cannot fix it for address, for example, somebody may have a big address, somebody may have two lines address, somebody may have door number, somebody may not have a door number. So if which type of fields we can fix it, which type of fields we cannot fix it, even though what type of data we are going to be fixing. So that is entire the type of data is very different. Okay, at the bottom of the data we can go, there is a number, that is a digit and character we can consider. So group of numbers we are going to be called as a different numbers, and group of characters we are going to be called a different things. That is different stream for everything. Okay, so for that one we have a number system and we have characters. Okay, so if the data is there, how we can organize the data in the probe? For that only we are going to be see all those things. So next one is about linked list. If the linked list is the data structure used to collection of sequence of objects that allows efficient additional removal of elements in the middle of the sequence also. So another one is about, this is the, so we are simply scattering the data in the, for example, it's simply we are going to be scattering the data in the memory. So how it will be? Once we are scattering the data, in order to retrieve time, we need to find it and we need to identify, we need to search a long time to retrieve the data. So if it is like this, so why won't we have some link with the data with other data? Why don't we follow some indexes? Why don't we follow some proper manner to arrange this? That is a sequence, the collection of sequence of objects. Sequence and objects that allows to efficient additional and remove elements. So where we want to add the data, where we want to remove the data, where we can add it. So what is the starting point? What is the ending point? Everything we need to know in a proper order, proper sequence, for that we are going to use a linked list. The structure of linked list. See that? I think you can see the diagram. The persons are linking with one person. Now, for example, simply the persons are standing over there. We need to talk about the center person, next person, third person. How we can say that? If they see that, now we can start from left to right or right to left. So the total 3 plus 3, 6, 7, 8 members are standing. So from left to first to 8 persons are standing. For example, if you talk about the left to right, so for example, we can take this one. This is the first number we can mention, and this is the 8th number. So which number, the middle one, who is the middle one? And who is the third person? Who is the fourth person? If I want to add the 9th person, where we want to add? Where we want to make a link? So which two hands are separated and which two hands are going to be inserted in between? That is the structure of linked list to understand an efficient way of arrays and the need for more efficient data structures. Magazine, a program that mechanism, a sequence of employee names. If employees leaves a company, the list must be removed. In array, the hole in the sequence needs to be closed by moving all objects, then come after it. Consequently, suppose an employee is added in the middle of the sequence, then all the names to be followed, new hire must be move towards the end, and moving a large number of elements can be involved in a substantial amount of processing time. So this type of how we are going to be add an employee, how we are going to be remove the employee, so that such type of places we use. A linked list structure avoids this movement. A linked list uses a sequence of nodes. Linked list uses a sequence of nodes. A node is an object that stores an element and references. Element and references. The references is nothing but we can call it in our programming point of view. So even a reference is also in a programming terminology. Our better understanding, we call it is an address. We can call it is an address. Okay. So that is a node which contains the two parts. One is a data part, another one is address part. It can simple as simple terminology up to now we know that. So that is an element and we can call that is a reference. What is that reference? A reference to the neighboring node in the sequence. That reference is also not for that node. It is the next node of the reference. Even if the concept of pointer here we need to remember. What is the definition of pointer? Pointer can store the address of another variable. So even if what element in the next, that address is, we are going to be storing. So once we are going to this, the link will be followed, the sequence will be followed. A linked list contains number of nodes, each of which has a reference to the next node. Yes or no? For example, Tom, Diana, and Harry. Tom have the connection with Diana. That is, for example, Tom can know the address of Diana. Diana can know the address of Harry. Okay, like that. So if we know one person, definitely what is the sequence of that person? The chain we can follow. When we insert a new node to the linked list, only the neighbor node reference need to be updated. For example, we need to add a remote in between Diana and Harry. So what we are going to be doing, we need to, no need to disturb the term, and we are going to be break the link in between the Diana and Harry, and we are going to be take the reference, and we are going to be inserted the Ramona in between the Diana and Harry, inserting a new node into the link list. The same is a tree when we are removing a node. What is the catch? The link list allows efficient insertion and removal, but the element access can be inefficient. So that is the insertion of node, and we are going to be delete. How we are going to be delete? If Diana wants to remove, so we need to take the reference. So now Tom gave the reference of Harry, and they both are going to be linked. For example, we supposed to want to locate the fifth element, we must traverse the first two elements. Yes or no? So that's why the I think, have you remember the concept of this insertion at the beginning, insertion at the end, insertion at the middle. While we are talking about the these terminologies, we talk about along the traverse also. I think if you remember, I will show you my PPT, then you can really remember that one. Okay. One second. I remember very when I was teaching that one. So when we are going to be talking about this linked list, whenever we want to remove or add anything, definitely we need to traverse the whole database. For example, how we want to traverse, we mentioned the implementation of stack, implementation of stack. And the sets, where is the linked list? Where is the linked list? Here. Yes, in my screen is visible to everyone, which PPT which I was taught earlier. Even just I am going to be showing, even if we discuss clearly in upcoming class. See that? So this is the deletion and traversing. We combinely and we talk about both. This is the one we are discussing now, deletion and traversing. So why we want to traverse in order to delete it now? So we don't know where the node is available. If it is the first node, if there is, for example, they said you can delete the seventh node. They didn't say that. Even if you want to delete the seventh node, we need to find. So we, for example, we are standing at the starting header. We need to traverse this first, second, third, fourth, fifth. We need to traverse all the. So that is a deletion at beginning. So starting, we can delete it. Deletion at end, so we can delete the directory. Delete a specified node. How a specified node? For that, we definitely we need to traverse the whole node. Yes, sir. So that is the purpose. So I think the line we can you understand very clearly. Suppose if you want to locate the fifth element, you must traverse the first code. This problem, if you needed to access the elements in arbitrary order, the term random access. It is computer science to describe an access patterns with which elements are accessed in an arbitrary, not necessarily in a random order. That is inconsistent. The sequence access visit elements in a sequence. Visit in the elements in a sequence. Of course, if you mostly visit all the elements in a sequence, for example, to display the print and SL for a display order for a print. So how you are going to be printed? For example, you are simply print an array. How we can print the array? Can anyone say that? For example, I want to print an array element. I don't know. Simply a of 10 is there. Okay. For example, a of n. We don't know what, how many numbers are there in it. If I say 10, we can hear the 10 values printed. For example, n numbers. So if I am asking to print array of n numbers, how we are going to be print the array? So that is how we are going to be display that n elements in the array. For that, how we are going to be write a code? Can anyone say that? Orally, you can say that. Yes, anyone? How we can print n numbers? Or else, for example, another way we can say that, for example, if you want to find the node at the top one. For example, if any node, for example, in array we can contain n numbers. So that is a finding. How to find a number in the array? How to write a code? Can anyone remember? For example, simple ga cheppalante, for example, naaku register number teliyadu, tana class teliyadu. I just know simply he is from IT department. Nenu aa name ni pattukoni IT department lo elaga vetadu. Ela vetadu cheppandi. For example, we can say, for example, Abdul Kalam. Some of the name is Abdul Kalam in our IT department. Okay. I want to know that he is in which place or which class. I don't know his section. I don't know in which year he is studying. I don't know his register number also. Even if now we can, the way register number, we can find it which year also. So I don't know anything. Just I know the name. So how can I sort out everything? So directly I will come. For example, our classroom starts from, for example, 44. So first I will enter into the 44. I'm going to be called Abdul Kalam is there. If not there, what I have to do? I have to go to the next one. Next, that is the next room. Next room, next room. Up to where, up to how many rooms I want to check? When I need to find the Abdul Kalam in a particular. For example, if I find 44, no need to traverse the other room. You can directly find the element in the first room itself. So, if for example, if I ask total how many classrooms are there in IT department, if I ask. So, how we can? Okay, so 44. So, in how many classrooms are there? So, we don't know. If there are empty rooms are or whatever it may be. So how to find, for example, for 3 2 6 rooms. So where is that 6 rooms? How we can find? So first room, second room, third room, fourth room. Every room we must visit and we need to say that yes, in 44 we have some students, in 45 we have some, 46 we have some students. So we have to list it. That is the display purpose we need to. Or it's a print also. So for that only we are discussing how to print. Array if n elements are there, how to print? So we simply we are writing a code. For example, I equal to 0. We are writing a loop. I equal to 0, I less than some n. What is the any elements we are going to be enter already in a previous? Enter the number of elements we are going to be writing n. No? That same n will be, comes here. I equal to 0, I less than or equal to n. Less than or less than. Can anyone say that? We are going to be use less than or equal to, only less than. Anyone, please. Less than or equal to. Whenever we are going to be talk about array concept, we must know about the index 0. If you are starting with a 0, n minus 1 is a maximum length. So we should not use minus that is a is equal to less than or equal. You can simply you can use less than I less than n I plus plus. So how many values are there? That many times you are going to be print. For example, percentage of d. So for example, you can consider this is an integer array. Percentage of d, then a of I. So I value 0, it is going to be print. I value 1, it is going to be print. I value 2, so up to n minus 1 is going to be print. Yes, sir. If you are going to be print, definitely we need to move from the starting to end. So every element has to print. No? If a equal to 10, directly a equal to 10 print. But a of 10, we have 10 numbers. How to print the 10 numbers? Definitely we need to take one by one value and we need to print. So for that we are going to use definitely loops. So inefficiency of random numbers is not a problem. If you use a linked list, we must linked list when you are concerned about the efficiency of inserting, removing elements, and you rarely need to access the need elements to access in a random order. So the Java arbitrary provides the linked list in the Java util package. It is a generic class, just like an array list class. That's we can specify that the elements and angular brackets, that is a such a linked list, that is a string linked list, that is employees like that, we can use in generic classes. So in order to avoid the runtime errors, we are going to use a generic one. The table shows the important methods of linked list classes. As you can see from the table, there are methods for accessing the beginning at the end of directive. However, you visit other elements, you need to iterate. So working with a linked list we are going to be talk about. So how we are going to be create an object for a class. So this is simple. We have a list, a linked list string, list equal to new linked list of string, that is. So generally we don't use this one general creating object for a class. So we are going to be mentioned in a generic type in order to mention. So it is an empty list. Okay. A list add list of array. So we are going to be add any element into that particular list. Same as list dot add a first Sally. So add the element at the beginning of the list, that is new element is going to be added before. So that is now we can link a list. We are going to be use like a stack top. The newly added element will come to at the first. List get the first elements. So first element will be always that is static. So that is array we are going to be implement through the array. So the linked list is going to be implement by using array like. We get the last element. What is the last element? So string remove the list of remove the first element. So always that is returns Sally is removed and the list only contains array. It is used the removal like element. So what is a list iterator? An iterator encapsulates a position where inside the linked list, conceptually, you should think of an iterator as pointing between the two elements. Just as the cursor in word processor points between the two characters. In the conceptual view, think of each element as being a link, a letter in word processor, and think of the iterator as being like blinking cursor between the letters. So simple how we are going to be take a positions and how we want to view the conceptual view of thinking of elements. So obtain the list of iterators in the list iterator method in a linked list class. So that is we are going to be see the dots here. We are going to be mentioned that is a continuation here. So list iterator string and the iterator equal to employees names of list iterator. So note that the iterator class is also a generic type. Iterator class is also a generic type. So list iterator string iterates the through a list of strings. So list iterator books visits elements in the linked list book. Initially, the iterator points before the first element. We can move the iterator position to the next one, iterator dot next to. This method throws the no such an element exception if you have already posted in the list. We should always iterator has next before calling the true method. So that is if every time we need to call if iterator has next, then what is each and every time we need to call about. So whether it is already fit or not. If you not, it is the what is the iterator each and every time we want to call. The next node returns the element that is iterator is passing. If you want to use an iterator list, the return type of the next node, next method is string. In general, the return type of the next method matches the list iterator two parameters. So that is the string name equal to, so where we want to store that one. Iterator dot next is going to be stored as a name, string space name. So it is going to be stored as a name. So see that how this iterator is going to be featured. So before that we talk about how to add and remove and what is the first node, how we are same here. Iterator string is what iterator. Iter equal to list iterator. Provide an iterator for visiting all the list elements. So string space s equal to iterator next. So assume that iterator points beginning at the list of Sally before calling the next method. After calls, Sally is became the point at the iterator previous iterator set. Set is nothing but we are going to be add. So we are going to be added. Set method is used to update the elements to return by the next or the previous. The list is now is duly used. Okay. So has next. So returns false because the iterator has the end of the connection. So if each and every time we need to check with the has next, if has next, then we are going to be the next one. So that is a next to what we want to insert. So that is see that if iterator has a previous one, set s equal to iterator replace. Has a previous returns the true because the iterator is not at the beginning of the list. So the previous and has next are the iterators methods. So again we are going to be add Diana and how to see the next and how to remove. So see this one initially the iterator position. So this is the blinker lines. These lines is drawing now. So iterator position at the before the D. Then returns D, it is going to be called to the next after Diana. So here the D, there is Diana, H is Harry, R is like that some names we mentioned. So what is the next? It is going to be moved. Then after inserting J, it is the cursor is moving to the next. The conceptual view of list of iterators. So this is a simple program for that. And the next one is about stack. So we will see these stacks in the next class. Today we saw about what is the linked list and what is the iterator classes. And how we will see the data. Okay. So far you have any doubt, you can ask me. So I'm trying to send through the WhatsApp why I know it is not getting. So definitely I'm trying to send you all the files through WhatsApp also. I think all the PPTs in the Google Classroom is there. Can someone who is in a fast internet, you can download all the PPTs and we can send in the group. That is better, I think so. These PDF which I am teaching now, that I will share through your I will try to send whether it is sending or not. I don't know. Maybe it is a very long file that is not accepting it. So. You cannot send this message. I'm getting like that error. Okay, can హలో మేడం మేడం చెప్పండి మేడం 3:30 కదా ఇవాళ నాకు ఇది అడ్మిషన్ డ్యూటీ ఉంది కదా 4:10 ఇప్పుడే అనుకుంటా మేడం క్లాస్ అయినా ఒక్క నిమిషం ముందుదే మేడం ముందుదంటే 3:20 to 4:10 మేడం వస్తాను మేడం చెప్పండి మేడం మీరు